how some YouTubers don't show you which books they're holding? I find it pointless. If they don't show me what books they're gonna talk about, why would I ever click on their video? Hello, my name is Fenoretti. In this video, I would like to present to you a list of my top 5 most disappointed books of 2019 and a list of my top 5 favorites with 2 honorable mentions included. 2019 was the first time I ever participated in the Goodreads challenge, so I challenged myself to read a book per month. A little history lesson about me and my relationship to books. Up until I graduated from high school, I was always currently reading a book. I was never rushing through it, but I always had a book that I was currently reading. So, some of my statistics for 2019, for anybody who cares, I read 30 books in total. My shortest book was Opal, which was 38 pages, and my longest one was After We Collided, with 674 pages. This is a list of all the books that I read. So the way I'm gonna present this list is like a sandwich: worst book, good book, worst book, good book, and we'll get to the most disappointing and the best one at the end. Okay, number 5 for the most disappointing, we have After We Collided by Anna Todd. My standards for this trilogy have always been low, and this was actually a reread. After was one of those books that I read when I was like 16, 17, and I was really obsessed with it. I knew it wasn't well written, but I was obsessed with the concept of fixing somebody that's terrible, and then I got into a relationship and I realized that people cannot change unless they want to. After We Collided was a very disappointed book, because basically there was no plot, we were just repeating the same dramas again and again and again. It was fucking pointless, and it was just a very, very, very long book, and I really wanted to DNF it, but I was trying to find the joy that I once felt while reading it, so I just continued through it, but I couldn't be too disappointed because I had already read it and I knew that it was gonna be that way. Okay, but on the positive side, my 5th favorite book of 2019 was The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. So The Song of Achilles is basically a reimagining of the myth of Achilles and his friend Patroclus, and they meet when they're kids, and it's kind of like a first love kind of story written in a very, very lyrical way. I consumed this story on audiobooks, and I feel like with books like this, it's better to have it physically in front of you because the writing is so beautiful that you need to fully get immersed into it. So I feel like the reason that this isn't higher on the list is because when I actually consumed it, I missed out on some of its beauty because I just listened to it and I wasn't 100% fully focused on word by word. But this is one of those books that every single word counts, and it has a purpose, and it has a meaning, and it has a feeling that it's gonna convey. So I really, really loved this story, and it's actually part of my wall decoration. It's up there, but it's a spoiler, so I cannot show it to you, but it's like the quote, "What has Hector ever done to me?" And you know the before and after of what Hector has actually done. Yeah, it's quite an amazing love story, and I really loved the aspect of first loves because it's my favorite love trope. Let's move on! Number 4 for worst books. Cool Down the Hawk by Maggie Stinfather. I had to look in my bookshelves to read her name. Oh my god, I'm impressed I can read that far, to be honest. Basically, in Cool Down the Hawk, we take 2 side characters from a different series and we have a story about them and their families. And the reason that this was very, 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 very disappointing was because the Raven Boys series was a very atmospheric, character-driven story. And Cool Down the Hawk is extremely aggressively plot-driven to the point that the characters don't even really matter. Why are we supposed to care about any of this? I don't even remember most of the aspects of this story. A very, very boring thing to read. My sentiments getting into this book was that I really loved the Raven cycle. I even have them up on my wall over there, but I'm gonna replace them now because my love for them has faded because of this book, because I was just like very, very disappointed. My 4th favorite book was The Host by Stephanie Meyer. Okay, this book is extremely long, and it was edited actually. I read it in Greek when I was like probably 16. It was around the time that I finished reading Twilight. I had already watched the movie before, and the movie is one of those that I revisit like every year. It's one of those movies that I love watching a lot. I don't know why, and I really like the love triangles in this book because it's not a real love triangle, because in my brain, the way that I see it is that if you have 2 options and you don't know who to choose, choose neither, because none of them is worth it. That's how I see it. If I ever have 2 options and I'm like, I don't know who to choose, probably neither, because you should know, and if you don't, it's probably they're not good enough to individually to be important to you. What I liked about this is the fact that the love triangle that exists is not real. So this is a story about aliens inhabiting human bodies. So we have this human that's called Melanie, and an alien called Wanda is now living inside her body and controlling it. So we have Melanie, who has a boyfriend, and Wanda, who is in love with a different dude. So the different dude loves Wanda, and the boyfriend loves Melanie. So it's like two different people caring for the same girl, but not really. So it's really emotionally intense, and Wanda is one of the purest humans. She's not a human, she's an alien. She's one of the most purest souls that I have ever read from their perspective. Wanda is precious, and I would die for her. I would kill for her. She's so sweet and caring. And like, I really loved the dynamic that Wanda and Melanie had with Melanie's younger brother, Jamie. Because I have two younger brothers, I'm very maternal. I love them so freaking much. And if anything was ever to happen to them, like if I was ever to actually genuinely kill somebody, it would be to protect my brothers. Like, these are the only two people in my life that I love that intensely. This book had this element of needing to protect a young boy, and I was just like all for it. I freaking loved it so much, and it's a very beautiful book, and I really loved the government system of this book. I have never read a better government system, and if the world worked like that, it could be beautiful, okay? I loved it. I loved it a lot. And I feel like the movie does some justice to it. Like, I love the movie a lot, don't get me wrong, but like, the book is so much more intense. Like, the movie is 2 hours and this book is like 1,000 pages. No, it's not 1,000 pages. It's like 600 pages, but like, still, this book is a journey, and you feel so connected to these people and their pain and what they're going through. It's beautiful! I loved it! Number three for most disappointing books, we have The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue. I've already ranted about this book before. Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue is a very, very stupid book. I hate books that the entire plot wouldn't exist if the protagonist wasn't an absolute freaking moron. Like, every conflict that happened in the book was because Monty was just a fucking idiot. Like, if he wasn't just a fucking moron that made every single bad decision ever, the book wouldn't exist. And there's an element of a love story in there. It's sweet, but whatever, I don't care. He's a fucking moron. He doesn't deserve love. No, no rights for Monty. He doesn't deserve any rights, okay? He doesn't. Let's move on. My third favorite book of 2019 was Wolfsong by DJ Gloon. Okay, this is gonna sound irrelevant, but if you're one of those people that thinks Edward is too old for Bella, don't read this book. This book is not for you. But if you're somebody that doesn't get triggered that easily, this book is for you. Wolfsong is a fantasy about shapeshifters, and it's very, very poetically, lyrically written. This book has amazing word repetition that every time it repeats it, another stab. Every time it repeats the, like, some phrases, you're just straight to your heart. Very well written. It's about first loves. I loved it tremendously much. So this book has my favorite audiobook narrator, who is Kurt Graves. He is incredible. His voice is calming. I didn't expect to love this book, and I started listening to it, and I didn't go to bed. I just didn't sleep through the night, and I just had to spend my whole day without any sleep because this book was that good. It really makes you empathize with a character who seems like he has some sort of mental disorders or mental disabilities, like he's a bit slow. This is a very long book, and it was a very long audiobook as well, but there was at least 4 times within the year that I listened to the whole first part again, which was my favorite part of the audiobook, because it was just that good. And I think at this point, ooh, I've reread it twice at least, and just read the first part again and again and again, because it's just so beautiful. And it's part of a series, and I think the last book was just released, and I'm waiting for the audiobook that's gonna be released in like a day. So, oh, I loved it. I loved it a lot. I just realized that I have like 1 bar left in my battery, so we have to run a marathon. Okay, so the second worst book was the sequel of this one. It was Wayward Son by Rainbow Rowell. So this book was just, not this one, the sequel, okay? It was pointless. What was the purpose of it existing? Now I want to get rid of this one because the second one was so bad. It was just a pointless, boring book that had nothing to offer. It was just disappointing. And I hate how you make two characters get together at the end of the book, and because you've already, like, completed the relationship arc, you feel the need to ruin it. Why ruin a relationship? Why make it so hard? They're teenagers. It's not that deep. Oh my god, why? I think I will read the third one just because I'm a masochist. I really, really, really was disappointed by the second one. Upon reflecting, the first book wasn't even that good. But like, you only realize it after you read the second one. You're like, yeah, I think it wasn't good ever. Okay, my second favorite book of 2019 was Tiger Lily by Jodie Lynn Anderson. Tiger Lily is one of the most beautiful books I've ever read. It is my favorite reimagining of Peter Pan. And now that I've seen him paired with Tiger Lily, there is never a moment that I would not choke Wendy with my own hands just so Tiger Lily can have Peter for herself. I already hate Wendy, so it wouldn't be even that hard for me to just kill her. It's a very, very beautiful book. Heart-wrenching, heartbreaking. It gave me one of the most intense heartbreaks of my life while reading a book. It was so immensely impactful, especially to me, who I find Peter Pan to be the most important aspect of what makes me myself. So reading this book and finishing it, it was a huge, huge heartbreak, and I felt real pain in my heart. So I would 100% recommend it to anyone who doesn't even know anything about Peter Pan. This is just a beautiful, beautiful book that handles so many different topics. Absolutely brilliant. So my most disappointed book of 2019 is book number 2 from this series, which is called The Raven King. Oh my god, what was the point of that book? It was literally a pointless book. Then we have an extremely, extremely graphic sexual assault scene that was so, so unnecessary for a teenage drama. Oh my god, I wish I could delete it from my memory. And if I knew that this was gonna happen, honestly, I wouldn't read the book. I wouldn't read the whole series, and I would be absolutely fine with it. If you're invested into reading the series, honestly, the second book is just skippable. There's nothing that's happening. Just skip it and go directly to the third one. Like, it was pointless. The second book of this series. Terrible. No. Absolutely no. So let's get to my honorable mentions of 2019. I read Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe, which was a very beautifully written book. But while I was reading it, I was like, can we get to the point? Can we just continue with the story? Like, I just wanted it to end. Like, I enjoyed it. It was good. But I haven't spent that much time thinking about it. Having said that, This drawing are from this book. But like, I need to replace them, but I don't have a printer. It's gonna be a movie, but like, I hate the casting. Another honorable mention has to be They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera. So this is a book that has a kind of big spoiler at its title, and while reading it, I kept being like, there has to be a plot twist at some point. And there kind of is, and there kind of isn't. This is a book that tells you everything you need to know in the title, and it's about people knowing that they're gonna die at the day of their death and finding each other and having a connection. It's a love story, and it was very well developed. Although I didn't like one of the voices of the characters, not the protagonist Mateo, but the other dude, I didn't like Rufus. I didn't like the way that he was speaking in his narration that much. He was too like swaggy. But like, apart from that, this was a very heartbreaking book that really makes you believe that you can love somebody and truly love them, and not just be in love with them, but love them within one day. Incredible. Really, really good book. And finally, oh my goodness, for my favorite book of 2019, it's Called by Your Name. Okay, this is the good cover, because I've actually left the English version of Called by Your Name in Greece, because when I was at the airport, my luggage was too heavy, so I had to leave like 10 books behind. So Call Me by Your Name is the second audiobook I've ever listened to, and it's the one book that I've read most in my life. I've read it, at this point I don't even know, like 9 times in English and 1 in Greek. 8 times in English, I don't remember, but I've read it only once in Greek, and every other time it was in English. Narration is amazing, it's from Ami Hammer. At this point, I feel like it's a joke in my channel. I talk about this book all the freaking time. This is the most beautifully written book I've ever read in my life. This book really influenced everything that makes me who I am at the moment. This is the book that made me fall in love with reading and knowledge. This is the book that reminded me that writing can be very philosophical. And I've also made like an entire video about it that's like, wait, over there. Yeah. So this was my favorite book of 2019. I love it with my whole heart. And obviously I love the movie as well. Like, the movie is what made me want to read the book. I watched the movie first. And it's just a great adaptation of a great lyrical masterpiece. And I feel like this is one of the best books of this generation. In conclusion, these were some of the best and worst books that I've read in 2019. I really wanted to talk about them because I would never have the chance again. And I'm just happy I made this video, okay? Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye. By the way, I don't know why, but my previous video just blew up for no reason. I know it's not viral or anything, but it made so many views, and it's like one of the worst videos I've ever made. I don't get why. What about it made people want to click on it? But Regardless, I want to thank my 4 new subscribers. I'm so honored that you chose to stay after watching that random video. Thank you so much. 4 people, that's a lot. I really noticed it, so thank you so much for subscribing. You know how some YouTubers don't show you which books they're holding? I find it pointless. If they don't show me what books they're gonna talk about, why would I ever click on their video? Like, I want to know what you're gonna talk about so I know I'm not wasting my time. Because if you're just holding like 5 Sarah J. Maas books, why would I ever click on that? So, here's the books! Is this upside down? Oh, this is upside down. Is everything upside down? Most of it is. Oh my god. Is it done? Is it good enough? I don't even know her. Do you like my hair?